men have been killed. Black women have been killed, sir. To me, that was a question.
May I ask you another question?
Yes, sir.
When people were running out, I heard a lot of people saying they shot someone else. Does anyone know or did anyone see who did the shooting? Or are you concerned that we're not sure exactly what happened?
I want it on video so you can put it on the news, right?
No, we're on live.
That's what you're trying to find out. If we got a video so you can elaborate out of it, make a fucking fabricated story.
Ooh.
You want a video that you can base a fabricated story on, right?
Amen.
Right?
All right. We're going to back up a little
animals,
bit.
Just animalistic.
There's a lot of hostility, a lot of skepticism towards the media.
I was in front of the Omni Hotel.
Absolutely. We can see that, Steve. Thank you for the interview. We're trying to get the stories of the people who are there on the scene to tell the country why they're there, why they're so upset, why they're near danger, and willing to risk their lives to make their points. And there's no better way to make them than in front of a TV camera. We apologize for the profanity. Obviously, this is a live protest, and we are covering it and seeing it for the first time, as you are. We want to bring in an exclusive interview tonight, which is the Charlotte Mecklenburg Police Chief, Care Putney.
Had to buy the Ritz-Carlton, so basically, they're going to go into the upper middle class white neighborhood, a rich area, and smash glass, bust up buildings, and riot because they don't want to do it in their own damn neighborhood. This is just ridiculous.
Who was shot to death by an officer in your department after that officer observed Scott inside a car. Scott exited the car, you say armed with a handgun. He got back into the car. The officers approached the vehicle. They told him to get out of the vehicle, to drop the weapon. Despite those commands, this is your version of it, Scott exited the vehicle armed with a handgun, and that is when he was shot.
But these people protesting, they don't care. They believe what they want to believe.
Keith Lamont Scott was black, and the community in Charlotte tonight believes that.
I hope the cops move in with SWAT team and everything and just get these people out of there. They need to really grow some, grow a pair, and just rush this crowd. Because otherwise, it's going to get out of control. These protests, they're not even protesters. They're just straight up criminals looking to throw rocks and bottles. The police, I'm sorry, but look at this crap.
Well, there's your truth, my truth.
The police are afraid to move in. I'd have the National Guard there and just bum rush the whole crowd. Look at this. Hey, at least they're throwing tear gas.
Can you see the monitor? Can you see Fox News right now on a monitor near you?
Yes. No,
okay.
I can see the camera only.
Okay. Because what we're seeing now is in Charlotte, an overhead shot, what appears to be canisters of tear gas and people running in and out. Have the officers been ordered to use tear gas to disperse the crowds? Do you know?
Absolutely. I'd get out a water cannon. I'd bring in a couple big water cannons and just blast the whole damn crowd with high pressure water cannons. They won't like that because all their little smartphones, they love recording. That'll ruin their little Apple iPhone.
Is there any doubt in your mind that there was a gun in the hand of Keith Lamont?
More to come.
And that a gun was recorded.
Oh, here we go. We got people running. Police officers are on the move right now.
Here we go again. Multiple people, one person shot in the head, dead. The ambulance can't even get to another person down. Cops can't even get to the ambulance, can't even get to them because of all these animalistic thugs. These, look at these people. They're not there to protest peacefully. Busting windows out of a Ritz-Carlton, busted up a Mercedes-Benz. They're in a nice area. They ain't looting and they're looting stores, but not in their own neighborhood. This is going down in a rich part of North Carolina.
Over again, and that is the police pushing forward with tear gas and a crowd really running in panic, running in chaos down the street away from.
I mean, look at these people. Look at this.
The line where at least one young man was.
And they want respect. This is not how you get respect.
And they lob tear gas in the crowd. The crowd simply reforms. A lot of people, especially young men, have their around their noses and mouths to try and shield them from the tear. As you can see, this is what's happening again right now. You hear a few smashes, a few...
Look, they're throwing the tear gas back at the cops. Look at that.
Young men and women run down the hill right in front of the Ritz-Carlton and the Omni Hotel as police and demonstrators...
Look at these idiots. Look at these animals. They're like zoo, like animals in the zoo.
Another young man injured. These protesters continue to stay out here through a cloud.
Look at this crap.
Tear gas. We have seen minor incidents of looting, at least one store.
Yep, that's a great way to get respect, guys.
But mainly it's a battle right now.
That's a good way to get respect.
And the line of police. Making back to
you. I mean, this. To taunt the police who have been told to hold the line and throw things at them and yell at them. And you can see, throw the tear gas canisters back at the police.
Unbelievable. And the cops just sit there and let them do it.
Outfitted to handle this kind of a situation.
Well, if the cops don't move in and start doing something to shut this down, it'll continue all night.
That was a flashbang grenade, that loud explosion.
Wait till a cop gets shot or killed. Then see what happens. Then they still won't do nothing. They're just letting these animals run wild. And they are. I'm sorry. They're animals. When you act like this over something that has nothing to do with you personally, and you don't even have the facts.
And paintballs. It chases the protesters away. It's this cloud of tear.
The kid had a gun. It was taunting police, and that's why the cops shot him. And all these rioters, they don't care, and they don't even know the real truth.
Tell the audience that we're just hearing that that apparently the local hospitals have taken in 8 patients. That's what we're being told. 7 law enforcement officers and 1 civilian.
Just pure animals, man.
Cops, 1 civilian. We presume the civilian is the person.
Criminalistic thugs.
By whom we have no idea. We have no idea. What we do know is that this started over the shooting death of Keith Lamont Scott, a man who is 43 years old, African-American, was in his car as the police went to execute a warrant for an arrest of someone other than Keith Scott at an apartment building. They observed Scott inside of his car. He got out armed with a handgun, so
yep.
Say police. Scott's family maintains it was just a book. He got back into the car. The cops
a book does not look like a gun.
The officers say they gave loud, clear verbal commands that were heard by many other independent witnesses that he get out of the vehicle and drop his weapon. The cops claimed that Scott exited the vehicle armed with a handgun and appeared to pose a threat. And that, we are told, is when Officer Vinson, who himself is African American, shot and killed Keith Lamont Scott. Again, a man who was in his car but had a gun and apparently got out of it, according to the cops. And then refused to drop it. The police trying to maintain control in the streets of Charlotte tonight. This is what they often do when they try to clear the street so they can either push protesters back from a particular area or protect a certain business or a particular area. And that's our guess as to what's happening now. I want to go back to our panel. Eric Gus.
Anderson?
Yes, go ahead.
That guy in the white shirt is actually a public defender. I just talked to him. He said he's not here with anybody. He's here to help people in the crowd. He actually almost got pulled in by police, as you saw, but then it appears that he reasoned with a police officer. There's more tear gas being thrown.
This is crazy.
Over the loudspeaker, but right now we cannot make out what is being said. They're telling people to control themselves and to leave, to disperse. That they will use physical force against them. They're about to disperse more tear gas.
Good.
People should leave immediately. It's actually being said in Spanish, believe it or not, Anderson.
Boris, I've just gotten word that there apparently has been 1 fatality. It's a civilian, and we're told that it did not involve a police officer at all, that it was a civilian officer.
How the rioters shot their own people. That's funny.
Again, we're trying to confirm that.
Good.
Get more details on that. We're obviously going to bring that to our viewers as soon as
go to bed. You guys got school tomorrow.
That gentleman there in the white and the tie says he's a public defender who's just trying to help out as much as he can. He has been very active in trying to kind of move back some of the more vocal protesters.
Not a white person.
As much as they move apart, then it seems like people edge back toward the police. Then the police reach in, try to grab some people that they believe are being particularly vocal or particularly causing trouble and arrest them. Sometimes that does seem to pass by. Yeah, go ahead.
I just wanted to mention, it appears that people here just got the news that you were talking about, that someone was killed. It's obviously on social media right now. and I just heard a woman screaming and shouting, crying, very angry, reading the news, saying that he was doing nothing. It doesn't appear that that news that it was a civilian-on-civilian incident has gotten to her yet. She's under the impression that it was police on civilian. She's very angry. So you can imagine this crowd is only going to continue to get angrier as that kind of, you know, misinformation or rumors start to spread about what happened. And we, again, don't have all the details yet. But obviously people here on the ground are reacting to the news that someone was badly, badly hurt in an incident at this protest, Anderson.
Is to take the side of the people who were against the police. Our first comments about this were anti-police. This is not a country which wants to see what we're seeing here tonight. Now, no matter what the excuse, this is not a country that wants to see looting. It's not a country that wants to see random violence. And again, you mentioned citizen upon a citizen. Well, watch and see how many people die in Chicago this week with no one noticing because they don't fit the current left-wing political mantra.
But the exactly.
Fact is, the current system isn't working. It's not working in education. It's not working in jobs. It's not working in safety. And that's why Donald Trump, I think, may do surprisingly well in the inner city, because he's at least offering a chance to dramatically change things.
That's right.
Newt Gingrich, thank you. I want to tell the audience that Hillary Clinton earlier today said there's still much we don't know about what happened here in North Carolina and in Tulsa, Oklahoma, but we do know that we have two more names to add to a list of African Americans killed by police officers in these encounters. It is unbearable, and it needs to become intolerable. And then she went on to say
yeah,
targeting police
Hillary,
officers
well.
Also needs to stop. Then she tweeted out, Keith Lamont Scott, Terrence Crutcher, too many others, this has got to end. However, we do not know what actually happened in these cases. An investigation is underway. The police chief you just saw, Care Putney, was on our air saying this man was armed and not obeying police commands. The Department of Justice is already getting involved in the Tulsa, Oklahoma case. They may get involved in this one, too. In fact, you can bet they will, because they've already taken hold of 26-plus investigations in this country. And
again, this is a tweet from the city of Charlotte, and what they are saying in total is fatal shot uptown was civilian on civilian. CMPD, meaning Charlotte-Mecklenburg Police Department, did not fire the shot. But the two pieces of news there from the city of Charlotte, they are saying that this was civilian and civilian, but also they are saying that that was a fatal incident. So that's the only further information we've got yet on that reported gunshot wound, which the city now says was a fatal gunshot wound. Excuse me. In terms of what Tammy Leitner was just saying about seeing an officer who was clearly injured, even though she couldn't see the source of his injuries or the nature of his injuries, she could just tell that he couldn't walk. She saw his head loll back when he was put down
wow.
In a seated position by his fellow officers. There is a tweet now that I can tell you is from WCNC, which is our NBC affiliate in Charlotte. They are citing Charlotte City Councilman Kenny Smith as saying that seven Charlotte-Mecklenburg police officers have been taken to area hospitals tonight. So again, seven hospitalizations of police officers.
These ain't protesters. They're just criminals.
We don't have
criminal thugs out to do
have
damage.
Source on that besides this Charlotte City Councilman, as reported by WCNC. And we don't have any news on whether or not there have been protesters who have been injured this evening as well. We have seen a heck of a lot of tear gas in the air. Joining us now on the phone is NBC News Gabe.
I really understand what's working and what's not working, because clearly in Charlotte we see it's not working. Mm-hmm. In Baltimore it's not working. Oh, right. In Ferguson it's not working. In Miami it's not working. Every city in this country we're seeing an outcry from the black community. We're tired of waiting. What's unacceptable to the black community is that another black brother has been slayed by the hands of law enforcement.
Slayed. He had a gun.
And I know Kevin is huffing and puffing, and he can continue to huff and puff, but
he refused police orders.
He's just as liable to get shot as I am, as Alton Sterling.
If these people would just comply and don't walk out of your car with a damn gun in your hand and ignore the police, maybe you won't get shot. It's not that hard. It's pretty simple.
That is where the hands up don't shoot lie
well,
began.
The Justice Department report talks about patents and other principles. People talk
they
about
talk about systemic racism within the Ferguson Police Department. Absolutely, hold on. Absolutely, they do. However, they also found that Michael Brown, the black decedent in that case, was charging at the officer who defended his own life when he shot him. I understand, Richard, but when you just refer to Ferguson, it's important that the audience understand what you mean. Let me get back to Kevin. Let me get the floor.